Having played just 9 games during the last 2 seasons, how has dealing with these injuries changed you both as a person and a player?
I'd say overall it just makes me appreciate the game a lot more and the experiences that I've had on the field and just being at Utah State. And a lot of people, I mean, I've always heard it can be gone in one play, and it was for a second, but overall it's just made me appreciate the game a whole lot more. Mentally, I was able to kind of get into, the finer parts of a play and really just connecting and communicating with teammates and all that. And I think it's helped me out in the long run. I want a career in coaching down the road, and I guess this was my internship.
What expectations have you placed on yourself this season and on this year's squad?
I haven't really placed too many big expectations on myself. I guess my biggest one is to try and elevate everyone else. And I think when that happens, I know Coach Heupel is going to call some good plays for us. And I mean, as long as I do my job and I keep other guys hold them to a higher standard, then we can turn like a 3-yard hitch into maybe like a 17-yard play, just because they know that they can do it and they work that hard in practice every single day. So I'd say more than anything, it's just motivating these guys each and every day.
Do you have any pregame rituals?
My biggest thing is I need to take a nap before. And it took me a while to figure out, but Steve McNair used to do that too. And so that was kind of cool. I'm not going to say we play the exact same, but apparently if he didn't take a nap, then he would just be mad the entire day, and that's kind of how I am depending on how I wake up. So yeah.
Despite the loss of Wimpy, how nice is it to have 4 returning starters on the O-line?
It's definitely nice to have 4 guys coming back. It's always going to be hard to replace a guy like Kevin. He did a great job whenever he was here, and I think the biggest thing is the confidence level that not only that I have in them, but they have in each other. And it's a family, and it's an incredible thing to be a part of. And I'm really excited to stand behind there and deliver some strikes, because I know I'm not going to get killed too much. So that's a lovely thing to see.
So that gives you more confidence, I would think.
Yeah, it definitely gives me more confidence. And I mean, that's another group that's, 4 of them are coming back, but they're still kind of young. So hopefully I can help them out as well, and we can produce a little bit more at the end of the day.
Most embarrassing moment?
In life? Ooh, in life, I'd have to say my one time was we were playing the Studio Wood Cobras at Booker T. Washington High School. This was whenever I was like 7, and I was playing free safety, and I hit this kid into a puddle, like a giant puddle. Now, in Houston, Texas, it's either the hottest it's ever been or it's some of the coldest it's ever been, and I remember I hit the kid directly into a puddle. They scored like 2 plays later, and all you saw, my mom's a photographer, so she has pictures. All you saw was me on the sideline with a quilt on me, a green quilt, and that was, I don't know if it was really that embarrassing. It was just sad to see now. I'm embarrassed about it now, but that was a tough day. We lost.
You brought up Coach Heupel's name. Mm-hmm. What's it been like working with him, and what are you learning from him?
Yeah, it's definitely been fun working with him so far. He's taught me a lot, not just the game of football, but how to be kind of a professional at the quarterback position. And that means staying in later after everyone else and getting there before everyone else. So it's ultimately being the ultimate leader, being the ultimate example, and then holding yourself accountable to every action that you have. And that's a huge thing, because after a while, once you get into the rhythm of it and the schedule of just doing everything early and late, it kind of just becomes just second nature. And so you think nothing of it, but other people see it. And I think that's a big thing about the work ethic of some quarterbacks. You think it's just what you do, but it's highly noted by everyone else. So I'd say the biggest thing is just being a professional every single day.
Give me one name on offense who's going to have a big year.
I think Brandon Swindle's gonna have a big year. He's a 5th-year guy. He went down last year in the second game on the first play, so his year got cut very, very short. But just to see all the work that he's put in, not just in the summer, but as soon as we got back from the bowl game. I mean, he's putting in work. He's he was here in May whenever some of the other guys weren't here, as well as other guys. So, I mean, it's not just him putting in that work. It's everyone, which is going to collectively make us better. But he's the guy who's gonna step up. He's gonna go get a high ball. He's physical enough. He's put on some weight to where he can kind of go across the middle. And he's long, he's lanky, and he can find a way to catch the ball. So I'm excited to throw to him.
What has the Aggie family meant to you?
It's meant a lot. It's crazy. It's crazy just to see how long I've been here and just to see all the people I've met. And I don't know. I always tell my mom, like, one of the biggest issues I have, just I guess from everything that's gone on, is everyone knows my name and I don't know everyone's name. And I think it's because people care so much. And so I feel like I just have to give back a little bit. And I think that's the biggest thing about it. You can take advantage of everything that they have to offer you, but I think a family is always give and take. And so I don't know, it's meant a lot. Especially for me, since I've had to sit a couple times. I've had alumni talk to me that I may have seen maybe once, and they know a lot about me. So it's incredible to see how close-knit everyone is. I've seen a lot of alumni come back, and they're just standing on the sideline, and they'll talk to you just as if they've known you for about 20 years when you just met them the first time. So it's, like I said, it's very close-knit, and it's very intimate at the end of the day.
You have a message for Utah State fans?
Utah State fans, this is a big year. It's not just for me, not just for the other seniors, but just in general. We knocked down part of the stadium and we're about to build it back up, but there's no better way to start a new chapter than ending it with a great ending. So I guess I don't want to say this is the end of a stadium, but so I guess this is the beginning of Maverick Stadium. So I don't know. I'd say come out to celebrate with us the way that we want to celebrate, which is with a lot of wins.